So RFK Jr. is nominated to oversee a lot of the health agencies in the United States, including the NIH and the CDC and a number of others. So he's been in the news a lot lately. And one of the things he's been talking about is food, and specifically his concerns with seed oils.
Seed oils are one of the most unhealthy ingredients that we have in foods. And seed oils, they are associated with all kinds of very, very serious illnesses.
He's right. Seed oils are associated with a number of chronic diseases, but it's with a lower risk of them. Dietary linoleic acid, that's the main type of fat in most of these seed oils, is associated with a 15% lower risk of coronary heart disease events. That's things like heart attacks and strokes, and 21% lower risk of coronary heart disease deaths. So more linoleic acid, more seed oils, less heart disease death. When we look at the effect of cooking with different fats, following 500,000 people for 16 years, canola oil, that's one of the seed oils, and also olive oil were both related to lower total mortality. So lower risk of dying in people who cook with those fats. One idea out there is that seed oils should be replaced with animal fats like butter. Well, butter was positively associated with cancer mortality, so more dying of cancer. Substituting corn oil, canola oil, these are all seed oils, or olive oil, not a seed oil, for butter and margarine. So eating either seed oils or olive oil instead of butter or margarine was related to lower all-cause mortality. That's total deaths. Lower mortality from cardiovascular disease, lower mortality from diabetes, from cancer, from respiratory disease, from Alzheimer's. Conclusion, replacing butter and margarine with canola oil, corn oil, or olive oil was related to lower total and cardiometabolic mortality.
They are associated with all kinds of very, very serious illnesses, including body-wide inflammation.
Right.
So this is a very common question. Do seed oils cause inflammation? What does the science show? This systematic review and meta-analysis explains concerns have been raised about linoleic acid because of potential pro-inflammatory and also potential thrombogenic properties. However, this speculation is not supported by randomized controlled studies. Intake of linoleic acid was not found to increase inflammatory markers. We have a video going over dozens of these trials one by one, covering 6 or 7 different types of seed oil, heated seed oil, not heated seed oil, large amounts, smaller amounts, longer follow-ups, shorter follow-ups. You consistently don't see a pro-inflammatory effect over and over and over again. Actually, it's much easier to find studies reporting a decrease in inflammation with seed oils than an increase. Randomized control trials and observational studies support that higher linoleic acid intakes reduce LDL cholesterol, increase insulin sensitivity, so that's good. That's better glucose metabolism, and are associated with lower concentrations of C-reactive protein, IL-6 and IL-1 beta. These are inflammatory markers. So lower inflammation with more linoleic acid, more seed oils in some of these studies. So this thing of seed oils are inflammatory is something that gets repeated mechanically on social media, never showing any evidence because the evidence is all stacked in the opposite direction. Bottom line, bulk of the evidence not only does not support this idea that seed oils are this huge health issue, but it consistently shows that you replace seed oils with animal fats like butter, you make things worse. Okay, so how are Americans getting fat? Why do we have an epidemic of obesity? If it's not the seed oils, what is it? This is not a big mystery, guys. The average American gets most of their calories from ultra-processed foods, from junky foods, almost 60% of their calories. And we know that a lot of ultra-processed foods in a diet increases caloric intake. So this isn't some big conundrum. Ah, but a lot of these ultra-processed foods, they contain what? Seed oils. So it's all the same thing, right? Potato, potato. No. Because the worst offender among ultra-processed foods, both for weight gain and for risk of disease, is sugar-sweetened beverages, soda, which contains no seed oils. And when we look at the seed oils themselves, not in a Twinkie, but added to foods or to cook foods at home, we consistently see benefits, not harms, as we already saw. So it's not about the seed oils. It's about eating junk. Junk with seed oils, bad. Junk without seed oils, still bad. And junk with butter instead of seed oils, still bad. And actually, according to decades of science, it's worse than the junk with the seed oils. It's a step backwards. Focusing entire health agencies on random stuff with no understanding is a waste, is a massive waste of resources and a wasted opportunity, because we could be addressing things that actually make a difference. Maybe make whole foods cheaper and more accessible so that people don't have to eat so much junk, so much ultra-processed foods. Or maybe try to make ultra-processed foods healthier, but with something that's actually documented by science, not going in the opposite direction with seed oils. This is a complete distraction. All right, but seed oils make massive amounts of money. It's a huge industry. So it's all a conspiracy, right? I mean, just follow the money. How is this helpful exactly? Okay, let's follow the money. Seed oils are very profitable, so follow the money. They're out. What are we going to eat instead? Let's go with butter. Oh, wait. Beef and dairy is a multi-billion dollar industry. So follow the money. Those are out. Let's go with olive oil. Pretty much everybody agrees olive oil is healthy, right? Oh, it's a massive industry. Follow the money. Chuck the olive oil. What are we supposed to do? Find charities that produce food for free? That's the only thing we trust? I mean, this is such a silly argument. Whether a food or product are profitable or not tells us nothing about the health effect. Don't get me wrong, money can corrupt. I've turned down every offer of sponsorship, every link to industry on this channel since day one. I don't even know how much money I've left on the table because I'm an idiot like that. Also, I want it to be completely independent. When I sit down, I can tell you exactly what the science says, and I don't care who likes it or who doesn't, because there's nobody writing the checks. So yes, money matters, but we have to apply this consistently. If seed oils are suspect because there's a lot of money involved, then all other foods are suspect. If big pharma is suspect, then the supplement industry is suspect. That's a serious approach, not picking and choosing. Yeah, but everybody's sick, and everybody's getting sicker and sicker. So the science isn't working. Let's just forget about science and try something else, right? Except that it has no basis in reality.
Rates of heart disease have actually been on a slight decline for the last 30 years. Rates of heart disease deaths in the U.S. have fallen abruptly for over half a century.
Entire infectious diseases have been eradicated, have been eliminated, thanks to scientific advances. Polio, eradicated. Measles, essentially eliminated in the United States. Smallpox, eradicated. Cancer used to be a death sentence. Nowadays, many types of cancer are very manageable, curable even, with radio, with chemo, with surgery. AIDS used to be a death sentence. Very manageable nowadays with modern medicine. And life expectancy, how long we live overall, that's kind of the bottom line. It's gone straight up. With the exception of a couple blips, a blip in the pandemic, it's a straight arrow up for the last 100 years. So this idea that we used to be so healthy and now everything's worse is a gross misunderstanding. Some things are really bad, obesity epidemic, diabetes epidemic, and other things have improved amazingly. So we want to fix what's not working. We want to keep all the stuff that is working. Now, I don't think that RFK Jr. is the problem. Feel free to disagree. I don't think Trump is the problem. I think these are symptoms. People are done with the corruption and the lies in these institutions of power that have abused trust. The government, the mainstream media, these guys lie like they breathe. The healthcare industry in the U.S., the insurance companies, are completely predatory. Anybody who opposes these institutions and this system, people are going to go with that, even if it's incredibly flawed. And I don't blame them. I get that, and I largely agree. Scientists have to learn how to talk to people, how to talk to the population, how to convey the science. The science communication during the pandemic was atrocious. And then people wanted to outlaw what could and could not be said and boss people around. And a lot of this mayhem that we're seeing now is blowback from that stuff. I'm not surprised that people are going to TikTok for their health advice. Yeah, the science might be terrible, but at least they talk to people. They speak their language. Nobody is bringing science to the population. Scientists aren't doing it. So people are going to go with whatever alternative is available. I'm trying to learn. I'm trying to get better at communicating science to people. I've learned a boatload from you guys' feedback, so please keep it coming, because We got to work together. We're either going to float together or sink together. Here's more on seed oils and inflammation. And here's a video on seed oils and liver health. Some really interesting recent trials. I'll meet you guys in there. Take care.